Thank you guys so much for being here today. I'm sure you all know about my husband, Zach Sauer, who was attacked last year and died due to brain injuries caused by the attack after 9 months of a coma. Our family has tried to constantly cope with the situation, and we have found two ways. The first is the memorialization of Zach to Zach Sauer Brain Trauma Research Fund at Johns Hopkins. This fund provides money for laboratory and clinical research of brain trauma, as well as continuing education for the medical staff in the Hopkins Neurocritical Care Unit. The second is a group of legislative issues dealing with pride and victims' rights, collectively called Zach Law, which we will present in Annapolis. In order to gain public awareness about Zach Law, Melody Simmons from Exhibit A magazine interviewed me about it. When I read the article, I was shocked to read that spoke with Martha Burns, the state's attorney's office, grossly misrepresented the evidence and medical position in Zach's case during her interview for the article. Marty Burns told the reporter that Zach's case was not what it appeared to be. She had great doubt on whether my husband died from a street beat. She described multiple details that have no basis in fact. She cast doubt on my credibility in representing those facts. I called her at her office after reading the article. That same day, I called her on her cell phone and sent her an email. I left messages on both phone lines. After 4 days of no response, I finally received contact via email letter. She stated that she wanted to keep the matter private and that we must seek forgiveness, and not in any way that may appear insincere. Desiring a more personal response, I called her again and eventually spoke over the phone. Stated that she was vastly misrepresented in the article. I contacted author Melody Simmons, who believed her representation was accurate and stands behind her article. She reviewed her notes from the interview, and the notes support her stance. In making erroneous statements in a public article, Marty Burns made this issue a public matter. I have asked that she publicly apologize and retract her statement. She has refused by stating that she has no further comments on this issue and that I am to refer to her email letter. As a result, you have hurt my integrity and my ability to lobby for Zach Law and to help others who might one day face a similar situation to my own. She has stated that she does not want to silence my voice as I speak for victims' rights, but she has drained the credibility of my words with her statement. While she defends that the state's attorney's office works hard every day to ensure that victims are treated fairly and with compensation for compassion, Dr. Murphy, Zach's physician and director of the Neurocritical Care Unit at Johns Hopkins, has even come out to publicly state that he's saddened and appalled that our justice system is capable of such callous commentary with little or no regard to the grief and suffering that can be placed in light of Zach's murder. He has also stated that Ms. Burns' slanderous inferences have added to our torment and ability to cope. If Marty Burns would truly like to show her sincerity in this matter, she can simply issue a public apology and retraction. To date, she has not. Margaret Burns, if you are as sincere as you say you are, you will come out of that courthouse right now and publicly apologize for and retract the statements that you have made. This is your chance to be accurately represented. You say that you have been misrepresented in the public arena. Now you can publicly correct the errors that were made.
Come out now!
Margaret Burns fired. You can also sign an upcoming petition to get Margaret Burns fired. after today, you could continue to make an impact by voting. This incident could have happened to any one of us. If we stay informed about our local politics, we can choose competent officials to run our city. But in order to choose competent people, we must register to vote, and we must show up on election day to cast our ballot. When informed voters vote, people like Justin Mead and Burns do not get elected or re-elected. You can also visit ZaxHours.com and continue to follow the story so that it stays fresh in your mind. The state's attorney's office is hoping this will all just go away. Don't let it. If you have the means, please donate to the ZaxHours Brain Trauma Research Fund at Johns Hopkins. Help keep Zach's legacy alive. The fund can only exist as long as there are donations. Finally, you can follow the progress of Zach's law as it makes its way to Annapolis in January. Show your support of this collection of legislative issues by writing to your congressperson, expressing your desire to see this bill go into effect as a law. Together, we can give Zach's legacy a purpose by binding together to make our city safer and thus preventing future crime victims. Thank you very much.
I guess not. Okay.